Do you want to improve your Python coding? How about programming the computer to play a game of battleships against you? So you're going to play against your computer. So you're writing the code yourself in Python. So this continues the battleship game. Now, the code we've already started. We have three videos where we created the board. The second video asked players to shoot, and we checked that shot to see if it was a hit or sunk the ship. And the last video, the computer created the ships. So this video, we're going to look at how a computer can shoot. And it's in two halves. The first half is this video. The second half will be the next video. We're going to actually program so the computer will not only shoot, but it will shoot tactically. Okay, here's part A, where the computer shoots. The last video, the computer created the board. So now let's just change that. Instead of using a cross, we're going to use the zero. And to show the board, we're just going to keep that, but we're going to say show board underscore C, so we can say that's the board, not that we're playing with, but what the computer has created, the ships it's created. We also want to change some code in the check OK. So we're looking for numbers ending in 9. We're just going to change that code because that's a bug. Now, this video, we're going to look at getting the computer to make guesses. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste the code before that got the shot from the user from the first video. Now with the computer, we don't need to enter in the details. So what do we need to change? So let's say get shot from computer. We have the guesses. So that's what's gone before. So we don't need to have inputs. But we need to make the shot a number, a random number between 1 and 99. Now we did that before, can you remember, using rand range 99. So we can just copy that code. So we can say shot equals rand range 99. Now we know it's going to be between 0 and 99, so we don't need that statement, but we need to know if that shot is in guesses. So if the shot is not in guesses, then we know it's okay, and then we can break. The only thing we need to do, we need guesses and append that shot. So now we have a computer that can guess where to hit the board. So we need to return the shot and the guesses because we've changed that, and we need to call it. So we've created the boats, the ships, shown the initial board, and now we need to return shot and guesses when we call the function getShot comp from the computer, and we need to pass that the guesses. Now if we want to see that, we can use the original show board. So let's just paste that in from before. You see we had show board from the first video, so that's not the same as the board the computer has created the ships on. So create board, show board. Now here we've got hit, miss and comp, so we need to create these. So let's start off with hit and miss and board and comp.
and also guesses. So at the beginning, these are all empty. Now, show board, we don't return anything. So we just have hit, miss, and comp. But the shot from the computer has to be placed in one of these. Is it a hit, a miss, or does it complete a ship? So that's the next part, is to check the shot. So again, we can go back to our code we had before and copy and paste our check shot in. Now, can you remember we had the example of two bolts, and then we passed that to the check shot, and then we checked to see if they were in bolts one and bolts two. So now we have to change that, because we've got the create bolts from the computer. Let's call that ships to make that clear. So now, instead of having the boat 1 and boat 2, we've actually got the ships that the computer created. So we need to change this check shot from having these boats to the ship. So we need to change this check shot. First of all, let's take the boats out and change that to ships. So we're going to pass it ships, and we're going to return ships. Okay, so when we call check shot, we can see what we're going to pass that. So once we get the shot from the computer, we need to check that shot, and then we return the ships, hit, miss, and comp. And then we're going to see the board after that. We will put these get shot and check shot in a loop, but let's just change the function first. So what have we got? We've got the ships. So we can say for, we'll use range, and there's a reason for this. When we go for the for loop, if we just say like for boat in ships, when we change boat, it's not going to change the details, the numbers inside the list of lists. So ships is a list of lists, and when a shot hits one of them, we need to change. So what we can say is for I in range of length of ships, and then when we go through this loop, instead of having a boat, we can have ships and I. So let's move that code over. So we can start changing boat to ships I. So we're going to remove the shot. If the length of the ships I is greater than zero, is we're going to append it to hit, else we're going to append it to comp. So that's going to stay the same. Now we can remove this boat 2, but we can't just say append to miss, because we're going through a for loop. So therefore, if we use an if else here, we're going to have every single shot in miss. So what we can do is we can say missed equals 1. Missed. What we're going to do is if a shot hits, either to complete the boat or just to hit, then we change missed. So then we can say missed equals 0. Let's put that in the correct place. So, and now we can, after the for loop is finished, we can say if missed equals 1, then we can append the shot to miss. So what we're saying here is the shot is going to be put into the list of miss if it hasn't hit the ship, which is what we want, any of the ships, because remember we're going through a loop. So if you like, the list of lists called ships has several boats, 2, 3, 4, and 5 length, and we need to find out which shots have missed all of them. So we've removed the shot, so we return ships, and we've got hit, miss, and comp the same as we had before. So we can remove these bolts because we don't need them. So we've got create bolts. We can look at the bolts when they are created. Now let's have another loop. Let's see, 2 shots. We're going to get the shot, and then we're going to check it, and then show the board. So let's run that, see if it works. Okay, so this was the original board that the computers created, the ships, the boats. And here you can see just 2 guesses here. The first one at place 8 and the second one at place 90. So that's correctly shown the board as well. Now let's try it with quite a few more shots. Let's say 50 shots. And there's obviously a lot of tables. We won't even be able to look at the original. But you can see here there's a lot of crosses for misses and a lot of O's for hitting the ship. So that's worked. The thing you can see here is it randomly chooses where to shoot, but that's not going to sink many ships. Normally when you play, if you get a hit, then you know that the squares around that hit, there's likely to be more of that ship, that boat. So therefore the next stage is to be able to play some tactics and code the computer to be able to recognize a hit and to make tactical decisions about where to shoot next.
Thank you for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe.